this right now, let me tell you, is 10:35, and then you guys can see the outside is all dark, but I really want to get this done. Okay, as we all know, when we have y to the first power times y to the second power, of course we can just add the powers up together and we get y to the third power. But have you ever thought about what if we have y prime times y double prime? What are we going to get? Oh well, why don't we put down y triple prime? This would be so cool, isn't it? However, you know, this right here is not always true, but it's true for some functions though, such as the linear function. Because the linear function, which is like y is equal to mx plus b, if you differentiate that twice, the second derivative is 0, and the third derivative is also 0, and you end up with 0 is equal to 0. That's kind of cool, but it's kind of boring. That's kind of trivial. So in this video, we're going to find out more functions so that their first derivative times their second derivative will be their third derivative. So check this out. And yes, I did do this on the other day, but it was too long. You can just do the following right here, right? So here we go. First of all, I'll just write this down right here for you guys. The goal is to find y, and let's say y is a function of x. And we want that the first derivative times the second derivative to be the third derivative. And let's see. And in fact, I will take a substitution because we have a third order nonlinear differential equation. I would like to reduce this a little bit. In fact, if you don't do that, it's actually okay. If you just kind of be careful with the notation, it's up to you. But anyway, I will begin by saying, let u to be my first derivative of y. So I'll just say u equal y prime, like this. Well, this right here will be, okay, we have the u times y double prime. Of course, you put prime here, you put prime there. That's legit. So you get u prime right here. And then that will be equal to, and let me actually leave some space, you will know why. Y triple prime, you put two primes here, you put two primes there. And you get u double prime here. Very nice. That's legit. And now, what can we do? Well, the truth is that you see you have u times u prime. Doesn't this remind you of the Chen Lu questions? Yeah, you have to think about the derivative of what function will end up to be u times its derivative. In fact, we can just integrate this right now. And the truth is we can integrate both sides with respect to x, because u is a function of x. And also, this is a nice form. Because you will see that this right here is going to be just 1/2 u squared. Let me tell you guys why. First of all, if you differentiate this, put the 2 in front, you just get the u, right? And the minus 1, of course, for the exponent. And don't forget the Chen Lu. You have to multiply by the derivative of u, which is exactly u prime. And you're done. So when you integrate this, it's very nice to get that. Very nice. And then I'm going to put down a constant here. Let me just say plus c1. And on the right-hand side, when you integrate the second derivative, you get the first derivative. So I will just say this is equal to u prime. And I don't need to put down plus c, however, because if you do put down plus c2, you can just minus c2 on both sides, which is still going to be a constant. So that's the typical deal. And now, notice u prime is what? This right here is nicely equal to du dx, because u is a function of x. U prime is just this, right? Like if you differentiate this, you just differentiate that pretty much. And on the left-hand side, this is what I would like to do. Let me factor out 1/2. I think it's going to be easier. So I will do that. And right here, inside here, we have u squared. And from c1, I factor out the 1/2. I should get plus 2c1, but that's just another constant. So let me just put down plus c2 like this. And here we have a separable differential equation. So let me divide this on both sides, and let me multiply the dx on both sides. However, I want to work with the u's on the left-hand side. So when you divide this right here, I'll put it down as 1 over u squared plus c2, and then the du right next to it. And then if I multiply dx on both sides, I will have the 1/2 with the dx, like this. So this is wonderful. And as usual, we can integrate both sides. So let me just put down integration here and integration here. And yes, this time I remember to put down the integral sign after the equal sign. About to integrate both sides. Integrate both sides. Yeah, I was tired on the other day. In fact, I'm still tired. This right now, let me tell you, is 10:35. And then you guys can see the outside is all dark. But I really want to get this done because of the video I make on the other day wasn't good enough. Anyway, we continue. Here's the deal. To integrate this integral, we have to consider three cases. Case one, let's say c2 is 0, right? So we have this being the integral of 1 over u squared plus 0, and then du, and this is equal to that, which is the integral of 1 over 2 dx. And we are just going to deal with these little baby integrals. When you integrate that, you get negative 1 over u, and that's where we put the constant on the right-hand side. This is going to be 1/2x plus, let me use c3 because I have the c2 over there already. So that's what we have. And now I'm going to isolate u, and this is how we'll do it. So here we go. I'm going to take the reciprocal. So you have the 1 over, and then I'll multiply by the negative on both sides. And then you will get 1 over this, right? And then you have to multiply the top and bottom by 2 so you can get rid of the little complex fraction. So overall, you will get negative 2 on the top over x. And then when you multiply 2 with c3, so you can just put down a c4 like this. And u is, of course, dy dx. And when you put down dy dx, you can multiply dx on both sides. So in other words, dy is equal to negative 2 over x plus c4 dx. And then we can integrate both sides. And we get the left-hand side being y, and then the right-hand side is negative 2 natural log of absolute value of x plus c4, and then don't forget another constant plus c5. This right here, if you differentiate once and twice and three times, you will get that. Really cool, right? So I'm going to let you guys do the differentiation on your own. So now, case 2. That's the case when c2 is greater than 0. But I'm not going to do the general case. Please don't ask me that. So I will just pick an easy number for c2, OK? I will just say pick c2 to be 1, positive 1. Very nice. And with that said, you are going to have the integral of 1 over u squared plus 1 du. And this is equal to the integral of 1 over 2 dx, like this. And then when you integrate this, you will get inverse tangent. And then when you integrate that, you are going to get 1/2x. And then let's say plus c6. And as I said, you will get an inverse tangent. Let's take the original tangent on both sides. So you get the original tangent of this guy. And then you have the u on the left-hand side. And the u is, of course, dy dx. So I can just put that down as dy here and then dx here. And I can just integrate both sides right here for you guys. So with that said, you will get y being, okay, when you integrate tangent, you get natural log absolute value of secant of the input, which is 1/2x plus c6, like this. But you have to do the reverse chain rule, right? The derivative of 1/2x plus c6 is 1/2. You have to divide it by 1/2, which is multiplied by 2, like that. So you are done with the integration. So in the end, you put on plus c7. Here is another function that when you differentiate 1, 2, 3 times, you'll get that. Really cool. I like to ask my students to differentiate, pick c7 to be 0, differentiate this part, you know, 3 times, and then have them verify that, which is really cool. Now, let's say case 3. That's the case when c2 is less than 0. And of course, please don't make me do the general case. I will just say pick c2 to be negative 1. Nice number, OK? So we have to deal with the integral of 1 over u squared minus 1 du. And then we have the integral of 1/2 dx, like this. This time, though, when you integrate this, of course, you get 1/2x. And we have ca now. c8. All right, here's the deal. When you integrate this, you actually end up with negative inverse hyperbolic tangent. The reason it's inverse because this is being flipped. Okay? So it's the negative version. So I'm going to multiply by negative on both sides, and I will get negative here, and I'm just going to say this is going to be c9, like that. Okay? Hopefully you guys don't mind. And then I will have the u by itself after I take the original hyperbolic tangent on both sides, like this. And then from here, I'm going to just integrate both sides. Well, this is du dx. This is dy dx. Oh my god, there are a lot of things. So I'll just put on dy dx, finally, like that. And then I'll integrate both sides. And then right here, I will get y equals, OK, hyperbolic tangent. It's like sinh over cosh. You do use up, yeah, up to you, whatever you want to do it. But it's really similar to that, except for you have natural log absolute value, and you have cosh of the input, which is negative 1/2 x plus c9, like this. But again, you do the reverse chain rule, divided by the derivative inside, which is going to be divided by negative 2, like this. So you have pretty much have this. And by the way, this is supposed to be cosh, like this. And then put plus c10. You can put the negative right here, and then you do the reciprocal. So this is actually the same as, let me just write this down again, y equals 2 natural log absolute value with hyperbolic secant of negative 1/2 x plus c9. Whoa, my god, so unfinished. Yeah, like this. Another function right here. And if you do partial fractions, seriously, just do it on your own. I'm not going to do the partial fractions. But here's a little interesting part. Where is the linear functions? Yeah, where's the linear functions? Didn't I say the linear functions will work as well? But where are the linear functions? Here is a special case, I will say. This is like the special cases right here. Well, we have to go back to the denominators right here. You see, we have 1 over u squared du, right? In this case, we have to set u squared equals 0, and then you find the solution. That's the missing solutions. So the first one, u squared equals 0. Well, of course, this means u is equal 0. And u is what? U is y prime, meaning you have y prime equals 0. And derivative what function will give you 0? Of course, constant functions. So from here, you know y is equal to a constant. So I haven't used c, so I just put on c. So first one right here. Okay. Second special case, the missing solution from here, I have to look at u squared plus 1 equals 0, like this. But this right here is good because it's not possible with real numbers. So don't worry, okay? All right, number 3. You're going to look at this guy and then set equal to 0. So you have u squared minus 1 equals 0. Of course, u equals 1 or u equals negative 1. From here, you know this is like saying y prime equal 1, and the other one is y prime equal negative 1. This right here, if you integrate both sides, of course, you get y equals, you get x, and plus, let me say this is c11, this is c12, okay? And then on the other hand, you can also have y equals negative x plus c13. And technically, you can put down some coefficient in front of the x, and the reason you don't see that is because I pick c2 to be negative 1, just a nice number. So hopefully you guys can see. So here we go. You have a lot of solutions for these guys. Whew, I am done. And hopefully you guys all like this video. And please give me a like. And if you guys like math, be sure you guys subscribe. Thank you guys so much. And as always, that's all. I mean, that's it. Bye.